Now let's look at question number 3 on centrifugal pumps. The question says, find the power required to drive a centrifugal pump which delivers 0.04 meter cube per second of water to a height of 20 meters through a 15 centimeter dia pipe and 100 mm long. The overall efficiency of the pump is 70% and the coefficient of friction F is 0.15. That would be used in the Darcy-Weisbach equation. Okay, so we need to find the power. So you are given the discharge, which is 0.04. Okay, we have the value for the total height, which is a sum of the suction head and the delivery head. So capital H, which is a sum of the suction head plus delivery head, which is 20 meters. The dia of the pipe is 15 centimeters. We can assume that the suction pipe and the delivery pipe will have the same dia. So DS will be equal to DD, which is 15 centimeters, which is nothing but 0.15 meters. This means the velocity in the suction pipe and the delivery pipe will also be same. The length is 100 meters. So again, we can say that the length of the suction pipe would be equal to the length of the delivery pipe. Not equal, but I would say you will have to add it. The total length is 100. Okay. The overall efficiency is 70%. So eta O is 0.7. And the coefficient of friction is 0.15. All right. Let's first of all find out the velocity. So the velocity in suction pipe will be equal to velocity in discharge, Q upon area, 0.04 by pi by 4 into 0.15 square. This would give you a velocity of 2.26 meters per second. That is the velocity in suction pipe and the discharge pipe. All right. Now we have this over here. I mean, there is some friction loss. So let us say the total friction loss, let us say capital HF, this is equal to 4 into F into L V square upon 2 into G into D. So you will get 4 into 0.15 into the length is 100 into 2.26 square upon 2 into 9.81 into the diameter is 0.15. Okay, so this can get cancelled off easily. This would give you a total friction head loss of 10.41 meters. So this is the friction head loss. Now this friction head loss, is a addition of the friction head loss in the suction pipe and the friction head loss in the discharge pipe. Now with the overall efficiency, which is formula is G into HM upon 1000 into shaft power. Now HM is the manometric head. So we need to calculate now the manometric head so as to find out the shaft power from this formula. Now the manometric head formula is the total head that you have, that is 20 meters, plus the friction head against which the pump has to work, plus the velocity head. So this is the total head, which is called the manometric head, against which the pump has to lift water. Okay, so this will be 20 plus 10.41 plus 2.26 square upon 2 into 9.81. This would give you a manometric head of around 30.67 meters. This is the manometric head. Now, if you put the formula for this in action, so you will have your shaft power as 9.81 into 30.67, okay, divided by 1000 into eta naught, which is 0.7. This would give you a shaft power in kilowatts, because we are already dividing this by 1000. This will be 17.19 kilowatts. So this is how we have to solve this question. when you have this coefficient of friction given to you, means there will be some frictional head loss which would have to be added into the total manometric head against which this pump has to deliver work. So I hope you have understood this question. Now let's move on to the next video and talk about the minimum speed of starting a centrifugal pump.